Hello, this video we're going to investigate how to use the world generator which is included in the voxel generator. The world generator is the main tool to create procedural environment such as terrain or planets. Also, in this video I'm going to use a new headset in order to increase the audio quality, so enjoy it and take a snack and a little drink. So here, we are in our sample scene, and the first thing we want to do is to create a world generator. The easiest way is to simply go to voxel generator, and here we have our prefabs folder, and here is a new folder called world generator, and then you can choose one of those and drag them into the scene. For example, here we have one which generates a planet. So what do we see here? Here we have a small little planet which got cut in half in order to see in the interior. So now let's investigate how this stuff is generated. First we have here our voxel generator. The voxel generator is very basic and it uses the Margin Cubes multi-texture as hull generator in order to have multi-material setup. Here we can see that the outer shell has stone material, and usually planets get hotter when they are closer to the core. And here we have the molten core, which is the inside and is standard for every planet in our universe. Also here we can see that we have here an applied subsystem called world generator. This sample here also has no save system as it is not required here. When we scroll down, we can see here the world generator. Here we have the seed. The seed is required for randomness. And also here we have additional information. For example, we have here the algorithm cluster. Here we have an indicator of how many works are being processed. The reference generator, which is the voxel generator here. And here we have other options, like if it should be scale invariant. This means that if you increase the volume size, it also has the same result. And also two options to generate them on startup and auto-loaded inside the editor. And if I destroy it and click on generate world, you're going to generate the procedural content. Now let's investigate how the world generator is made up. How is this generated? First, we have here algorithm clusters. Here we have a game object called world algorithms. This game object is just there to group it, so we have a differentiation between the hull generator and the world algorithms. And here we have our clusters. This cluster here writes into the target dimension 0, which is the solid geometry, and writes into a target depth of 6. And here we can see the mix-up of all algorithms. The second one does the same, but it writes in the target dimension 1. Target dimension 1 is used for the texturing, for the material. And in the previous video we have investigated how to work with multiple textures using texture arrays. So we are also using it here. Now what do we have here? First, let's investigate what algorithms are used for dimension 0. The first algorithm is to generate a planet. Here we have the world algorithm called world algorithm underscore Perlin noise. This is for the randomness, underscore planet, And here we have a variety of options. The first parameter is the world generator. The world generator here is evaluated and assigned automatically as long as one parent element here has the world generator. Here we can see this object as the world generator, so it is assigned here automatically. Here we have now the first important parameter for every world algorithm, which is the apply function. The apply function is important for deciding what should happen with the generated values. As you are able to mix multiple algorithms together, the apply function defines how they are mixed together. Here, the first one usually has the apply function set, which means keep the values which are generated and do nothing. The next one here, for example, implements the simple world algorithm underscore Perlin noise, and here we have our values and apply function set to subtract. So this is used to create those caves here, those little holes, as the evaluated value is subtracted from the previous values here. So this value is subtracted by this value. Here we have another function here, for example min. Min means that it will keep the smaller values. And here we have max, which means it will keep the larger value, the molten core. Also the planet script, but it has almost no noise in it. Also, there are other apply functions. Here we have add, subtract, min, max, and here we have inverted variations. Inverted means it will first calculate 255 minus the evaluated value. So the value 0 becomes 255, and the value 255 became 0. That's then inverted. So now let's play around a little bit. Here, when I'm going to change the values here, we can see that it will update automatically. For example, if I increase the frequency here and the amplitude, you can see here. Now it's updating. You can see here how the content is generated. 0.45. And here we have the. Okay, now other stuff is going on. Here you can really, it updates automatically. Now the amplitude is way too high. Can increase the frequency. Also, I reduce the radius. And here you can play around with all those values here. Now we have another shape. You have to work very, very slowly. So, in order to check what's going on, let's check this one here. For example, the noise. If I increase the frequency here, you can see here how this updated procedurally. Also here, we have a gradient. This one is used to it cuts away the upper half of the planet in order to see the interior. So if I disable it, you can see here now the full planet. Here it goes closer to the center and it becomes molten. So you can actually also disable this one. Here we have the sphere. Let's enable it. Let's see what's going on inside. And here we have our molten core. The molten core is a simple sphere, but we can also add here some randomness. It's the fractal settings. Are the standard values. I have think have to make it much smaller. Have to work with very small values. Get the now the molten core is not completely spherical, but usually because the material is molten in real life, we have here actually no noise, so we disable it, so it really is a sphere. But I can maybe reduce the radius a little bit. Here we have now a molten sphere. If I disable it here, you can see here the interior, but we want to keep it. And also, I have here the noise. I can change here the parameters here, for example, add. Now, the result when I am going to add the values here. But we are going to subtract. Here, if I click invert subtract, you can see here now other results. So you have to play around a little bit, and it updates in real time, which is really, really nice. And here we can see the actual noise when I'm going to add it. Word subtract. What's that mean? But we want to keep it as a subject. And here we have the dimension 1. We can also change the parameters here. For example, here we are going to increase the surface temperature, and also we can increase the fall off. Yeah, we have the fall off. And start value, I lower the start value. This off. We're going to the fall off, so it becomes more molten in the center. Now it's a very, very molten, basically a lava planet. So here you can play around with the values here. And also, this system also supports multi-blocks, which are implemented in the future. So if I increase the chunk cache by 1 and generate it, of course, we won't see anything now because the position is at 0. But if I use just a noise function, for example, I'm going to add this now to see the asteroids. And if I increase the hash now and regenerate, you can see how now we are in the outer regions here, and we can see here how the outside would look like. So it perfectly would connect to other blocks, as it uses the chunk hash here, which is a new parameter, which is especially useful for multi-block systems. Next, we have here our dimension value. The target depth here is also updated automatically, so if I change it to 5, you can see here how it reduces the resolution. Then 4, here we have now blocks, 3, it's even higher resolution, lower resolution. So here it's now like this. And if you go in the other direction, here it increases the resolution. Here this is also accepted. 8. And here we have our safety system. Because it's very easy to change the values here to something crazy here. So. But therefore we have the safety system, and if it is too high, we can see here that we are going to exceed the safety margin of 10 million voxels. You can ignore the warnings, but then you have to update it manually by clicking on the General Develop button. And here we have a summary of the errors. And here it clearly says that the dimension 0 is exceeding the safety margin. So in order to update it automatically, here this is now prohibited. We have to fix this error by decreasing the depth. And now all errors are gone, and you can play around again. Also, other errors would be if something is missing or if something would be null, then it would also prevent you from updating automatically, because very easy to break Unity if there wouldn't be any safe system. So luckily we have here the safety system implemented, so you can play around freely without worrying that something which will freeze or crash. So in summary, you have now learned how to use the world generator. The world generator is a multi-component system, which has the root component here. Then we have the clusters for each dimension and target depth. And then you have here the variety of algorithms. For example, we have here a gradient, oscillation, parallel noise, and parallel noise blended. And also here we have a variation which uses a texture. And if you want to get further into the world generator, then I recommend to go to the world generator scene. Here you can see a variety of generations here. You have here the planets, but also you have here samples for Terrain, and here we have Underworld, a cave-like system. Here we have another one. It combines two parallel noise algorithms to create the surface, and the second one is used for the interior. Here we have the planets, and can play around, and this one, for example, also uses the texture. Can use this texture for the heat map, and it creates caves for the interior, or you can see here how it looks like the inside, and also you can modify it. I hope you liked this video tutorial, especially with the new headset, in order to get a much, much better audio quality. So I hope you like it. Bye bye.